Chris Stanley says that he could tell the flavors, the different flavors of M&M peanuts.
No way.
50, no, of course not.
$50, 5 out of 6 was the final bet. 5 out of 6.
Was it 6 out of 7?
There's only 6 flavors in a bag of peanut M&Ms.
There's one flavor, peanut M&M.
There's 6 flavors.
They're not Skittles.
They're brown, yellow, blue, red, orange, and green.
Just because there's only that many flavors doesn't mean that we don't do 6 out of 7.
Okay.
First of all, we're going to do, all you can do is miss one. Probably by 3, this thing will be over. Yeah, there could be the occasional good guess.
Yeah.
You know, you had some kind of thing there.
Or my taste buds are so powerful that this thing's going to go down.
Well, it doesn't matter what your taste buds are. There's no flavor to die. It's like tasting a number. It's like licking a number and then telling you what number it is if you were blindfolded.
When somebody tries to eat those little M&M characters in the commercials, they're not going, cherry. They're just saying, it's an M&M. It's chocolate.
By the way, I hate anything that gives personality to stuff we're trying to eat. I hate it. I also hate any commercial that has the bugs afraid and trying to run for their life. That's not the way I want to think of bugs.
They shouldn't have personalities, or they have families. Actually, in some of those
Where's your blindfold?
I'll put this over my face. There's no way I can see through it.
Why can't we have a blindfold?
I couldn't find the blindfold upstairs.
All right, this is. All right, you swear you can't see anything.
I can't see anything. No.
You look like one of those Mortal Kombat characters.
I wish. Oh, fuck! The fuck was that?
You see it.
Jesus Christ!
Shit!
Who the fuck threw that?
Shelby.
I'm gonna fuck you up, Shelby. You fucking hit me in the fucking head with something, you fucking little cunt.
Look what he hit you with, a water bottle.
I should fucking fling this and break your fucking nose. Just fucking throw water bottles at me, cunt.
It's not full.
You little bitch. What the fuck? Seriously, you get fucked up. I will fucking hurt you. This is a threat.
It was a half-filled mini bottle. How bad
Don't throw
that
fucking heavy shit in my fucking head, you little fucking piece of shit.
Maybe he just thinks you're a fucking sideshow freak that he can throw shit at.
At least I can fucking not drag the show into a fucking cul-de-sac and make points. As sad as that fucking sounds, at least I can do that. So how about I fucking hurl this and I won't fucking miss?
Now you're mad at him?
Oh, I'm always mad at him. It just takes one thing to fucking really just fucking let it come out.
What? He threw something at you like you're a fucking dunce.
He's stupid as fuck. This is coming from me. I've said one or two stupid fucking things before.
And here we were going to have this fun thing. And
I want to make some money today, Ron.
No, you know what? You got hit in the head with a water bottle by Shelby. You know, maybe we shouldn't do this.
No, we should do this. Find out once and for all.
Holy shit, he's still feeling like he's in it.
Yeah, because he has no fucking conception of what's going on around him.
Now, Shelby, if I was blindfolded, you think you'd hit me in the head with a water bottle?
No.
Now, how come?
You'd probably crush my skull.
I could crush your fucking skull. I could snap your fucking neck.
Maybe you can't.
Oh, I definitely could. I could easily fucking take his neck and snap it.
But you don't have the reputation for that. That's why he hit you with a fucking water bottle. Because you're just some bitch that you can hit with a water bottle.
What the fuck?
What?
I'm going to start hurling shit at him fucking for real. I fucking don't give a fuck.
It's too late now. Like
Not for me. It's not too fucking late if I'm getting shit thrown in my fucking head.
No, 10 minutes ago you would have thrown it back in a thing. But this is like you long after the fact. Now,
it'll still fucking matter to me. I can give a fuck. I love to break his fucking face right now.
Look, let me explain something to you. In every group, there's that guy that fucking people treat like shit or physically hurt.
Yeah.
I guess in our group, that's you.
Yeah, no fucking way. No, that ain't fucking it.
Shelby, what were you thinking when you hit him with the fucking bottle? You were back in the suburbs?
Fucking little cringing bitch.
Cringing?
No, Shelby, I'm asking you seriously.
I just thought I lobbed it. It wasn't like a fastball.
Well, fastballs would be coming towards your fucking head.
Do you know where this guy grew up? Where he can fucking act like if somebody's going to fucking hit him with shit, what happened to him every day? You might as well kind of have a bum come in here and piss in his mouth.
Basically, I feel like I just drank some piss. And I gargled.
You did,
I gargled it. I gargled it a little bit.
You fucking did. I guess you're the bitch of the group. I didn't know.
Fuck that.
So what? You got fucking hit in the head like a dunce.
Oh, I can't wait to hurt him.
You're like the fucking sideshow freak where you can fucking throw shit at him.
No! I'm a human being with fucking feelings.
You know what? Are you a human being or a human doing, Chris? A human struggling?
Both.
By the way, this is just a chance for you to eat free M&Ms. All right, put your fucking water bottle or bitch hat back on.
I'm not. No, I'll fucking just turn around.
That isn't the way that's going to work. Put your fucking water bottle bitch hat on.
It's not a bitch hat. It's just there's no fucking, you know, blindfold. I'm putting it back on.
All right, you got it on?
Yeah, I got it on.
All right, Shelby's winding up.
Oh.
Ford steamer.
I swear to God, it's going to get real fucking crazy in here if that fucking happens again.
No one fucking believes you, Chris.
Well, then do it then. And we will see a fucking, you'll fucking watch a murder on the fucking air.
Chris, you got the fucking reputation of somebody that we can throw bottles at. So what? All right?
I'm out of water bottles.
You're a fucking cuck.
Fuck that. I'll fucking rape Shelby in front of you if that should happen. I will rape him and fucking...
No, why would I believe you when it already happened once?
Then fucking do it again. Throw it in my face again, Shelby. Do it, please. I don't even have a fucking hat on.
That's fucking embarrassing.
Yeah. I feel like a fucking idiot.
I don't have any more. It's like a challenge flag. I already used it.
All right. So... The office stooge, Chris Stanley.
Bullshit. Why am I the office stooge?
Fucking with a fucking stupid hat on, and you got hit with a water bottle.
Because my eyes were closed. It was the only reason I got the fucking guy hit with a water bottle.
I don't know.
Yes, you were sitting right in front of me.
Why'd you close your eyes under the hat?
Holy
you already
shit,
had the hat
fucking
on.
Fucking enjoying it. What the? Why did I get somebody's weird phone in my pocket?
Wait a minute, you have an extra... What? What the fuck just happened?
I feel this buzzing in my pocket. Does everybody here have their phone?
I have my phone, yeah.
I didn't think you were an Apple.
I have mine.
I didn't think you were an Apple user.
Home just called.
Who has a black phone?
Oh my God. I think I got a phone from home.
Oh, no.
Phone home, E.T. That's so fucking terrible. All right, anyway, the office stooge, Chris Stanley.
I don't like that title.
Circus geek, the person that everybody throws trash at. Why is that funny to you, Chris?
Because it's fucking an absurd statement. That's not true.
Jesus Christ.
Blown up.
Yeah. Hey, I have the wrong phone. That was annoying. Craig, you're on the Ron and Circus Geek show. Go ahead, buddy.
Hey, didn't Pepper Hicks stop doing that over-actor bit long time ago?
What over-actor?
Fucking twat.
You're a twat. If you get shit thrown in your head, you don't get pissed off?
Yeah, you're such a badass, Pepper Key. Come on.
I'm not saying I'm a badass. I don't have to let fucking things get fucking
thrown. We know you're not a badass. You just get hit in the fucking head with a water bottle.
I was blindfolded.
You didn't stay blindfolded. You pulled a hat over your eyes. Jack, you're on the Run of Fez show.
Hey, you know how much of a bitch you sound, you fat fucking cunt?
You're a little bitch cunt motherfucker.
Just do it.
Because I still want a fucking job.
And Ron, I don't mean to correct you, but shouldn't be the Ron and Fez featuring Circus Geek show? I mean,
fucking, that's right, Duck.
Plug something on you, Chris.
Sure. Hello. Dane Cook Unmasked, that's happening Wednesday, October 15th at 3 p.m. at Caroline's Comedy Club in New York City. You can go to ibang.com to still request tickets. That's happening in 2 days on the entirebang.com. Also up on the Entire Bang, there's a new Jeffrey Gurian article with featuring Joel McHale, Penny Marshall, and Richard Pryor Jr. because he jumps around. And Shelby, what do you have? Oh, wait, nothing. That's right, you cocksucker. Also, there's a Dan Perlman new piece called A Comic's Life. Bob Newhart writes back. That's all on theentirebang.com. And you can check that out by going to theibang.com.
Let's call it a bitch plug.
That's a fucking man plug.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't think a man would let himself get hit in the fucking head with a water bottle.
Anyone with a fucking... with their fucking eyes covered could get is vulnerable, all right? So I'm really the brave one.
Oh, no. I it could be hit, but then that person would have done something about it. So
what am I going to do without getting fired? I can't do it because I want a fucking paycheck. I want to fucking stay here.
Well, let me tell you, Emily, ask this. If you fucking put his nuts in your mouth, would you just fucking lick them because you want a paycheck?
No, I would not.
Would you bite down then and like a fucking man would?
First of all, I don't want to be in a position to have the nuts in my mouth in the first place.
Nobody wants to be in that fucking...
I would just spit them out of my mouth. I wouldn't bite down on them.
That'll show them.
All right, there's already a hashtag, Hicks is a bitch.
Great.
God damn it, Chris.
It could be somebody else. Let's look into this.
Matt, you're on the Run of Fez show.
Yeah, hey, one good thing we know with that head covering on, he obviously can't see because he couldn't avoid the water bottle. But then my other question is, how do you know it was Shelby if he couldn't see out of it, though? I think we need to try it again and see if he can tell whether Ron throws the water bottle or Shelby.
Well, first of all, I don't treat human beings that way. Throw a water bottle at him.
Thank you, Ron.
Plus, I have the cup of fucking water here. Shelby, what were you thinking when you chucked a fucking bottle at somebody's head?
I just thought it was a light lob. It was half of one of those mini bottles. I thought it wouldn't even barely feel it.
You know you're throwing fucking water at a board, right, you dumb fuck?
It has a cap on it.
You're throwing it. Who knows what the fuck could happen? I would have loved if it would have fucking thrown it off the board. You guys get shit canned.
You would have needed to do something like that because you weren't going to be able to fucking defend yourself.
I can defend myself against him fucking any day of the week. Why am I even have to say that? I was blindfolded!
But afterwards?
There's nothing I could do, legally.
All right, you want to do me a favor?
Yeah.
Like, if your girlfriend's over your house, right?
Mm-hmm.
And she's leaving to go back home?
Yeah.
Call me so I can walk her and make sure she's safe?
You don't need to do that.
Why?
I'll take care of her.
But you won't do anything.
Yeah, I would.
You would just sit by and watch her get raped.
That's fucked up.
Like, you watch yourself get raped today.
He's really jumped ahead a couple moves.
Yeah.
Can I ask you something?
Yeah.
Would Davey Mac have taken that fucking bottle to the head?
If he was blindfolded, yes. He would have been hitting... Anyone fucking blindfolded would have been hitting that fucking water bottle.
You miss... I can't believe how much you missed the point. Yes, it would have happened to you, right?
Yeah.
You were fucking JFK. You were defenseless, okay?
Yeah.
You were sitting in the back of the... You're driving through fucking Dallas... You're sitting in the back. But suppose it just fucking grazes JFK. He's going to just fucking get up and start saying, I'm going to get even with that guy? Or would he have been heading right for the fucking book depository fucking building, rolling up his sleeves the whole way?
JFK would have went to the book depository. Or the Knoll, depending on what you believe.
You took it in the ass today, and then you basically said,
yeah.
Don't ever bang me in the ass again.
I'm going to fuck him in the ass later. Trust me.
Someone says to you that if you get fucked in the ass, you can only fuck somebody in the ass back.
No.
You're not going to do anything. Because you never do, Chris.
No, trust me.
That's the reputation. No, I don't trust you. I saw you just
then you'll
like
see.
A bitch.
You don't have to fucking trust me. You'll
I
see.
I just saw you get treated like a bitch today. Look, don't take it fucking personal.
Oh, this is the most personal fucking thing ever.
Hey, our buddy Austin, what's up?
Hey, Ronnie, listen, you should give Shelby the $50 for hitting the bullseye of that big fucking waterhead moron, Pepper Stanley. Dumb fuck, I hit a gurry and cucked him. Woo!
Austin, you're the dumb fuck.
Yeah, a couple people did say you were Gurion's bitch.
I run some VO sessions with him, but no, I'm not his bitch.
BJ sessions?
No, VO. Oh, VO God. Sessions.
Is that Vaseline? No,
voiceover.
Oh. What's your hurry? You can't just say voiceover. You're not even saving time by saying VO. I can see if you were writing it, but saying it?
Yeah, they are.
That's ridiculous. Listen. In the S&M game, right?
Mm-hmm.
You're a fucking bottom to his top.
He'll never be a top, ever.
He just fucking smacked you with a water bottle and laughed in your face with about it ever.
That did happen.
Yeah.
I can't deny that.
Okay, good. That's all I asked for.
But the grand scheme of things.
Joe, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, Ron, back in Philly, what would you or your buddies have done if they got some shit thrown at their head?
Look, I can't, you know what? I'm not going to put Chris on that same exact fucking thing because it's a whole different time. It's a whole different thing, you know? Maybe you could go to HR and force Shelby to go to one of those bullying fucking strips.
There will be no HR here.
Like Richie Incognito right now. Smaller neck, though.
Go ahead, laugh at your fucking bully. Laugh at the man who fucking turned you out.
This guy is not a fucking bully. He is a little bitch.
Chris?
Yeah, what?
He wants a Coke. Go get him one, but first put your fucking pants down to your ankles and walk down there that way. Because he wants to see it. Unless you want one right in the breadbasket.
No.
That's a little snicker laughing.
No, there's no laughing. I have a cold now, too.
I know. You're awake for today's fucking show? You're still up?
Chris, what's next for you? You got to go for another fucking stent?
No. I think my heart's healthy.
You taking your cat upstate?
You don't have to take care of my cat over the next vacation.
No, it's coming back. Hey, Red Bear, you're on the Manifest Show.
Yo, Ronnie, it's time. Pepper Hicks got no fight left. One more race, and you got to send that centaur fuck to the glue factory, man. Good for you, Shelby. Don't take no shit.
All he does is take fucking shit.
Take shit or start shit. This fucking kid over here, he's the number one guy now. If there's any trouble pops up.
Good luck with that.
Hey, you check out any Boardwalk Empire this year?
No.
They're killing off characters fucking faster than you can believe.
They kill off Nucky?
I ain't saying yet. But if you've ever met Nucky, someone just murdered you in the last fucking 2 days.
Michael Shannon, okay?
I'm not going to fucking do a spoiler alert thing.
All right.
I just fucking gave you as much information. You know, what do you got to do before you understand something? Be smacked in the head with a water bottle?
No. Just curious. I worry.
You know what? Maybe you got a little brain hemorrhage from when you got fucking bitched out in front of everybody.
There was no bitching out. There was a fucking blindside attack. If that's a bitching out, then I don't know what to say.
That was your 9/11.
I feel as bad as I did on 9/11.
This is what it would... All right, imagine 9/11 if fucking Bush would have said this. Yesterday we were attacked by Muslim extremists. We plan on going to HR and telling them that if they ever do it again, we will retaliate. It just takes one more attack on this country before we retaliate.
For the folks at home, this wasn't like an Evian bottle. This was a Nestle Pure Life half bottle. It was like getting hit in the head with a baby bell cheese.
All right, let me see that thing.
There you go.
Are you telling me you'd want me to fucking sit here and Steve Carlton this thing at your head?
No, you throw heat. Like 90, at least.
Look how he fucking has respect for me and none for you.
Yeah, it's weird.
Like you're some fucking candy arm bitch from fucking single A ball.
Make it up to the triple.
By the way, what about your fucking cards?
I'm happy, but I mean, to hit four dingers in a row just to win, it has me concerned. You can't win like that every game.
Where's the series at right now?
Going into, it's 1-1 going into San Francisco.
And we're 7-game series, right?
Yeah.
The fucking kid was adorable that hit the walk-off. He's like fucking 2 feet tall.
Yeah.
It was like one of the Smurfs. Man, there was so much sports going on yesterday, then so many fucking TV shows. I haven't gotten around to The Affair yet. That's supposed to be tantalizing.
I missed Mulaney last night.
I saw the Mulaney.
I'm going to watch it tonight.
Yeah, I'm not going to spoil alert everything. I'll just say this.
All right, you're making the universal dick suck. Like, you're sucking a dick fucking sound.
What are you talking about?
Like the side where you take a fist and it's like you're sucking a dick.
Why would I do that to you?
You didn't have to be sucking. You could just be jerking it off close to your face.
God, laugh at your fucking master.
Master?
Yeah.
Fuck that masturbator. You know why? Because I'm going to jerk off in his fucking face.
You just took his line and sent it back to him. You know what I want you to do?
What's that?
I want you to take our fucking Christmas picture. Is going to be you.
Yeah.
Lined up to one of those old fucking record players that have like the big horn coming out of it.
Yeah.
And your head is fucking tilted sideways to the left. And it just says his master's voice.
Bullshit.
It'll be fucking Shelby saying shit.
Ain't gonna happen.
This was just retaliation for you hitting me in the face with a basketball that one time.
Forgot God, about that.
Hey, Remy, you're on the Run of Fez show.
I gotta say, Chris, I'm disappointed. You just let Shelby mount you like a bull and come right in your mouth.
Fuck that. There's no cum in my mouth.
Can you taste the rainbow?
I was gonna taste the M&Ms, I thought it was gonna be a nice M&M party.
We can still taste candy.
Fuck that.
Today.
Ain't gonna happen now. Bet's off.
Why did you bet a 50, by the way?
Because I fucking thought I could do it.
But I always told that gamblers think that a 50 is bad luck.
Well, it's perfect for me because I fucking won't win shit.
So how do you know we're not going to be fucking with you on this?
It's fucking off now. I'm not fucking putting a goddamn hat back on. My eyes have to be completely open. I don't trust anything anymore.
All right, I'll do it.
Okay.
That one's yellow.
That was it. It was yellow.
Stop bullshit, man.
It's yellow. I just watched you pull it out of the bag with your eyes closed.
No.
You're bullshit. No, it's fucking true.
I tasted it. It tasted like yellow.
Yeah, see, that's what I'm saying. That's what I said. What could fucking happen?
You could have won a fucking easy fitty for yourself.
I can't fucking win.
All right. My eyes are closed.
Yeah, they're closed, yeah.
Can you see it?
Yeah, I can see it, yeah.
Tastes like the sky is blue.
Oh, my God. Oh,
motherfucker.
What do I do?
You got
guys
it right.
Fucking with me?
No.
I'm not fucking
You can
with
see
you.
Through your eyelids.
I'm not fucking with you.
Or you can
see through your eyelids.
You got it again. Yes. Like I said on fucking Friday.
You're blowing 50 bucks right now because this fucking kid basically took it from you.
He stole 50 fucking bucks right out of my fucking pocket.
Nothing stopped me from doing a candy test.
I'll never keep my fucking eyes closed around him ever again. That's for fucking sure. Or blindfolded.
Well, the post-show cuddle nap is over.
Oh,
you fucking
shit.
Little bitch. You shut your fucking mouth.
That would be a slam against me, too.
I know. You don't care how fucking bad you look. You just don't care. It's fucking maddening. You fuck up and then you don't care. You fuck up on this. You fuck up your job and you don't care. It drives me fucking crazy.
Two men cuddling is not a bad thing.
Do you understand how fez you are now? Without even attempting to be? All right, I'm going to do one more.
Okay.
Now stop fucking with me.
I can see it.
That tastes like the last one.
Oh my God.
Yeah, it was another
You guys are blue. Fucking with me.
No, I'm no fucking here.
No, it was blue. I fucking saw you put it in your mouth. It's blue. I saw
that
the color.
That 50 should be in your fucking pocket right now. This is easy to do.
And now it's fucking burnt. It's done.
It was taken from you.
I just can't fucking win, can I?
Not as long as he's around to stop you.
Motherfucker, I couldn't win before you were here, and I won't be able to win after you fucking leave.
Is that supposed to be helpful?
No, but it's just the truth.
Hey, Matt. Matt, you're on the Run Fez show.
Happy Columbus Day.
Hey. Happy Columbo Day.
Hey, there's a strange noise in the studio. I don't know if you guys are picking up on it, but I think it might be the sound of Chris's twat growing.
It's all cock. My cock's growing. I'm getting hard in studio.
This is so fucking embarrassing.
This is pretty fucking bad.
Dave in Washington, you're on the Run of Fez show.
Hey, buddy. You know, I've seen this shit 100,000 times. What happened is Shelby, a young alpha male on the rise, quite accurately sensed the amount of bitch in Chris Stanley, and that's why he threw that bottle. Ronnie, you say that Chris took it in the ass and said, don't bang me in the ass again. From what I'm hearing, his response is more like, if you bang me in the ass two or three more times, I'm going to tell the warden.
I'm no bitch. I was taken advantage of, though, in a moment of weakness.
Ooh. That's great.
No, it's not. It's awful.
I thought it would be good for you.
No, bad.
Adam, you're on the Run of Fez show.
Hey, Ron, how we doing?
Good.
Hey, I'm looking the other way. I think Shelby's like that little kid who walks by the dog leash every day just fucks with him. Until one day that dog breaks the chain and just rips his head off. Can't really feel too bad, so that's the kind of look I got it.
Well, sometimes the old dog just gets down on his fucking knees and sucks a D.
What dog sucks dick? And I'm a man, not a dog.
Hey, Grant, Florida, you're on the Run of Fez show.
Ronnie, I think it might be a situation where Shelby's got a crush on Chris, and you know, next thing he'll be asking to carry his books home, and all this rape and not closing his eyes when he kisses and stuff is just kind of making him excited.
Is that it, Shelby?
Is that possible? Could that be the case, Shelby? Well, really, really infatuated with him.
He was calling me
first
that
time
pet
he
name.
Had his eyes covered. You went
I
after
know.
Him.
You start calling him Shelbo.
It's one of his names.
Yeah. One of his cute fucking names. So what's the other half? Darling Master?
No. It's Shelby or Cuntface. It could be a new one.
Is that what you call when you're coming?
No. I don't come near him.
You just let him hit you with a water bottle and steal your fucking bit that you're going to win $50.
Fuck him. I'm not fucking throwing the fucking cash up now. I'm going to get fucking more shit thrown in my fucking head. Fuck that.
I'm out of objects.
There's a Purell bottle right there. I can fucking see it. There's books. I'm not fucking trust you.
You're afraid of him.
No, I don't fucking want to get more shit thrown in my fucking head.
That's called fear, dude. You're working from a place of fear, not trust.
No, oh, there's no trust with that asshole. None. Why would there be? He falls asleep at the fucking board.
By the way, Don sent some stuff out this weekend. Did you ever even answer him?
No, I didn't.
How do you not answer your boss back?
I saw Fez responded. I thought that would have been he was the representative.
We need to interact more. Yeah. We need to be more social.
It's a trust thing, you know?
Yeah.
Now that my trust is broken yet again. because I used to trust him, and then
I'm not your fucking counselor. I don't give a shit. I don't give a fuck what's wrong with you, really. That's the fucking problem you're having right now. Oh. Gino Bisconte out. John, you're on the Run and Fez show.
Hey, Ronnie. Hicks, I'm disappointed. I always thought you would have been Tommy, not Spider. Hits him in the head with a water bottle. And he tells him to go fuck himself. And I don't know if it's possible, but I think I got a sore throat from listening to you on the radio. See ya.
It's impossible, John. I don't know what you're doing on your free time.
All right, here's Stephen Nightmares wrote this. Fez of what a... would have shouted the shit out of Shelby if he threw a water bottle at him. Pepper just took it. Fez more manly than Peps.
That's a weird email. Was he not listening?
I don't know. I don't know, Chris Stanley. I know one thing. I'm kind of fucking embarrassed to you. Feels like I don't even know you anymore.
You know me.
As the bitch.
No.
Do, 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 do. I'm kind of embarrassed for you, though.
It's one of the darker days around here.
Is that racist?
No.
Look at you so fucking quick. No, please don't. Please.
Yeah, I'm not a racist.
Please. Hey, James, Chicago, you're on the Run and Fez show.
Hi, this is kind of disturbing this morning, and I just want Chris to know that I know he's going through some hard times right now, but, you know, it gets better. Just remember that. It gets better.
Oh, thanks a lot. I don't think you really meant that.
Do we want to redo the test, but with Starburst tomorrow? Maybe that could work.
No more blindfolding.
The fact that that last caller is from Chicago must be it. But he sounds so much like that friend of Bill Murray's that from Ghostbusters and Stripes.
Hal Ramis?
Yeah, that guy sounded just like Harold Ramis. Fucking freaked me out. I actually leaned back away, going, I felt like I was listening to Harold Ramis. Go back and grab that call for me. Like you did with the beep, bop, boop. Matt, Rochester, you're on the Run Fez show.
Hey, Chris, if you're refusing to do the bet, that means that it's ending in a tie. So ultimately, you just lost the bet.
I have no what Jay Moore and Clayton Fletcher feel like.
Give us the fucking 50. You fucking owe it. You fucking afraid to do it. You fucking pulled out. That's it. It's like fucking high noon if you fucking hightailed it out.
Do you want the 50 in like a one... single $50 bill or two 20s and a 10, 5 or 10 fives? How are we going to split this up?
Split it up.
Do you guys want to take my address down so you could send me some of that?
I mean, people are in on this $50.
Chris will fucking give anybody money if they promise not to hurt him.
I don't need a fucking promise of anyone not to fucking hurt me.
All right, Liz Sets Fire says, my grandpa was getting stents same time as Fez. He was out partying with us this weekend, talking about getting cocaine and hookers, and he's 72. Fez is stressed out by Eliminator pool. Sigh. I know you guys said Fez came in here super stressed, right?
Yeah.
And super depressed?
Yeah. He was down.
Did you guys have any interaction with him?
A little bit, but it was like short, you know? Clippy. He just seemed very down. And
then I get asked to do the show this Friday, you know, the Opie show on Fridays. No Fez.
He could just be feeling paranoia and fear.
I don't know what it is, but maybe it's why they didn't ask him.
Especially with, you know, not in the, another week last week, you know?
What's the name of the new show?
Bennington.
It's not Bennington and Watley?
Bennington. Wow, that's just your name, Bennington.
You sound like you got a fucking water ball stuck in the gap in your teeth.
Stuck in the gap of his teeth? Have you been wearing your retainers?
Oh, fuck.
Motherfucker, my teeth are fantastic. You shut the fuck up and keep your fucking freak mouth fucking shut.
Maybe I'm not going to be well enough to do this thing tomorrow. I thought the neti pot would work for me. Hey, Lance, you're on the Run of Fez show.
Hey, what's up, buddy? Yeah. Hey, Shelby, try this. Hold the water bottle high in the air and shake it at Pepper. See if he shies away like a little scared fucking puppy dog. The little scared puppy dog.
I'm a fucking man. I'm not a dog, you crazy asshole. Yeah, that's right. You're the one crying.
I don't get it with you, Chris. It's kind of embarrassing.
Kinda. Who wants to get hit in the fucking head with a water bottle? Nobody.
I saw one guy who didn't mind today.
Does it seem like I don't fucking mind?
Yeah, it does.
That's fucking crazy.
You know why? I look over and that fucking kid looks healthy as hell. Like he don't have a fucking worry in the world.
Healthy? Have you seen him walk?
Do you now look who's turning into Fez? Where you're taking it off these other things and the personal stuff. Instead of doing what you should have just fucking done. Giving him a fucking lesson. Go over and try to put that fucking water bottle in his ear. That's what the bosses would have expected to happen.
Really?
Yeah. For it to be fucking over, physical, and then done. A quick physical explosion, and then finish. Then you two guys fucking shake hands and have a beer together. And by beer, I mean he takes a fucking can of slits and smacks it against your fucking fragile skull.
Bullshit! If I had nothing touching his fucking head again.
Did you point at your fucking crotch when you said that? Oh, he's just laughing away. You've been fucking branded, dude.
Says in the employee handbook, no physical altercations unless it's like short explosions.
You're saying that you fucking took a bottle and smacked him in the head with it.
I thought it was just an underhand lob.
Howard can't get in here because he said he made $8 instead of $7 at some fucking diner he worked at.
That's just fucking insane.
Have you talked to Howard again since then?
I shot him an email. He didn't get back to me.
Of course he's not.
Just pissed. As he should be.
I wrote to him, Chris was supposed to take care of this for you. I guess he fucking doesn't give a shit about the vets.
Oh,
attorney vets.
I care about the vets.
Really?
I look, fucking HR put up a giant roadblock. I don't know why. Well, we know why, but it was an insane reason.
You might have a hairline fracture. You're talking nutty.
No, this fucking head is too fucking strong to be hairlined by a goddamn water bottle.
We were like the Giants last night.
Ugh. Did you see the video that the Eagles made?
Yeah. Mocking them and then backing it up.
Yeah, that was bad. I don't know what the fuck Eli's gonna do.
I couldn't believe the Cruz cried.
Yeah, I couldn't believe what the fuck I was watching. I was like, what the hell are you doing? All right, your leg's screwed up. Keep it together, dude. You're the fucking top playmaker on the team. He was sobbing on the fucking cart.
Yeah.
Jesus, man, get a hold of yourself.
Who'd that remind you of? That was you being taken out of the cart after a fucking water bottle. And you act like you're grabbing your knee. I don't think there's even anything wrong with Cruz's knee. I'm telling you fucking flat out. I think he fucking dropped the ball, started crying, and then they carted him out through his tears. I think he's fine.
It was a non-contact injury. No one was touching him.
Not only was no one touching him, if you watch that thing, you didn't see anything happen to him.
It was really weird.
I mean, most of the time, if you see a guy, you know, pull an ankle or whatever, but a ball bounces off his fucking hands, and then he just starts crying and grabbing his knee. They bring a cart out.
And he starts crying, bawling.
That's probably what Tom Coughlin's saying as a game plan. If you drop a ball that easy on the end zone, just go down. We'll cart you out.
Tom would never say that. Wise.
But, you know, if you can't muster any tears, cover your hands with your gloves.
All right, Don Wicklin said, Potty Mouth Chris has now said the word fuck 229 times in less than an hour. New high, and then he puts, or new low. In case you think I'm fucking lying.
Let me take a look. New low. I'm going to guess new low. It's my anger talking, Don.
And yet you don't even reply to the boss. When somebody else said, you know, and I know that you had all right on your side, that you had responded to an email before, blah, 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 and then you just took it. From this point on, I guess Fez is checking on you. Is that what that came out? Fez is going to keep an eye on it. Keep an eye on your work. This is the lowest day that you've ever had here.
It's a bad one.
All because Shelby hit you with a water bottle.
That's the catalyst.
This was supposed to be your M&M test.
That was supposed to be $50 in my pocket. Now it's just depressing.
Mm. Well, I know there's a lot of complaints about your language. And that's one from a vice president in this company. A vice president who's had enough of this shit.
I thought I was doing better, personally.
Really?
Yeah, I did.
You're a fucking waterhead, Chris.
I know. My brain is dry.
Matthew, you're on the Ron Fez show.
Hello?
Yeah.
I think you guys are way too hard on Chris. I think he does a great job. You guys, if he had actually hit Shelby, you know he would have gotten fired. It's ridiculous.
First of all, in a million years, he wasn't going to fucking hit Shelby. Because Shelby had come back at him so fucking hard, knock fucking Chris senseless. Seriously. Might as well hit Sugar Ray Robinson before he fucking hit Shelby. That kid is a fucking boxer.
He would fucking drop like an accordion. Fold. That's it. That's
accordions don't drop.
Fold. They fold.
Maybe if Weird Al like burns his hands or something, he'd drop.
Go to
it.
Hell. I corrected myself.
Look, there's fucking Chris after work today, being taken out on a cart, sobbing into his goddamn gloves. How about this? You take your gloves off, because they didn't fucking work for you either.
Who's the guy giving him a pat there? Is that Clock?
Who the fuck that is?
Some bullshit trainer.
You're gonna really need to stop crying right
now. Yeah, the fucking Giants got humiliated in Philly.
Fucking
humiliated.
It was their first time they shut someone out in like 18 years or something. It was crazy. Like, the Giants are just a shit show.
First time they shut someone out in 18 years.
It was zero. The Giants scored nothing.
Are you saying the Eagles haven't had a shutout in 18 years?
That's what I read. Yeah.
That's hard to believe.
Yeah, I couldn't believe it. I was like, what? But yeah, that's what they were saying.
That's hard to believe.
Yep, since 1996.
Wow. Giants must be the worst fucking jizz-drinking team in history.
They're still trying to get their handle around this West Coast offense.
Well, they try to get their handle out of blocking. And giving that fucking boy more than fucking half a second to drop back. Hey, you're on the Ron Fez show.
Man, all it took was one half little bottle of water to hit him in the head, and he's like he gelded that centaur. Jesus.
It's fucking true. He took your nuts.
Oh, they're still here.
They're higher than they've ever been.
I'll take his fucking nuts.
A lot of people complaining that you're screaming at me and not at fucking Shelby. I've noticed that as well.
Like, if you just tuned in, you'd think that you threw the water bottle at him.
Well, Shelby won't fucking talk to me. He'll just make his bullshit comments.
He just made a fucking joke about you being a fucking stooge. He let it happen again. The fact that you stayed over there, that you didn't even walk across the fucking thing, I'm going to tell you the truth, Chris. That embarrassed me.
I'm embarrassed for myself. This is a bad day.
I bet fucking Davey Mack's partner from The Rat wouldn't take this fucking shit.
Carl?
What's his name?
Carl.
Carl doesn't fucking take shit from anybody. I guess that's why Davey Mack trusts him.
They're doing well, I hear.
They're doing really well.
Yeah.
I was listening to some, yeah. You know what that's like saying?
What's that?
My ex-wife is so happy now. She's having kids. It's great. So happy for her. You're very supportive of your friends.
Yeah.
Like Shelby.
No, that's...
You fucking throw, Shelbs. You caught me right in the fucking brain.
That's not a friend.
You've been told that you got to break twice a fucking half hour, right?
Twice an hour, yeah. We need to break.
And you didn't do it?
No. I fucked up.
What would you like to say now?
We should break?
No, what would you like to say to Don?
Don, I fucked up. I should have told us to break and we didn't. That's my fault.
And what happened with the guy that was going to keep an eye on it?
I don't know. I don't know what's going on in that room.
He's not saying a word, huh?
It's my fuck up. Or my screw up. I'm adding more F-bombs to my hour.
Apologize to Shelby.
That'll never happen.
Then we're not going to break.
We have to break. I'm not apologizing to Shelby.
Well, you need to take one for the team.
I already took one in the head for the team. Screw that. I'm not going to goddamn apologize to him.
The team didn't need that. Before I can go to break, I need an apology.
Apologize. I'm not apologizing.
You're already late for your break.
I know. I'm not apologizing. I can't apologize.
Let's just let bygones be bygones.
What bygones? No.
We'll just stay on the air.
We can't stay on the air. We have to
866
break.
866-RON-0-FEZ. 866-RON-0-FEZ. Jim, you're on the Run of Fez show.
Hey, buddies.
Yeah.
Huge Chris Stanley fan. I'm actually one of the people that gave him his Dreamcast for his birthday, but I got to call
him
out.
Nice, thanks.
Ronnie, you called him a waterhead, and his reply was, I know, my brain is dry.
Yeah.
Let's see, what would be the opposite of a waterhead? A dryhead, which would be a normal human being.
What?
Yes. Think about it. It's logic.
No, there's no logic. People don't have dusty brains, Chris.
The brain is pretty wet. I think a waterhead is one that's just overflowing with liquid.
Then my brain is properly liquidated. We really need to break.
Yes, but I have to have closure first. I need an apology for Shelby. And then I'll go into break.
I can't live with myself if I apologize to him.
Hey, Chris in Colorado, you're on the Run of Fez show.
Hey, Ronnie.
Hey.
Hey, it's a good thing Pepper Stanley didn't do that candy challenge because I'm sure every flavor would taste yellow. You yellow belly son of a bitch.
Oh, but one man died in Bitter Creek. He took some water to the head.
No, he didn't.
Stanley. Scone is the one who ran.
We got a break.
What do you do when you're Chris Stanley and you know you're a man? Yeah, I want to go to break. Give me some closure and apologize to Shelby.
What if I promise to get him back? To fucking make him...
Just apologize to him. That's... Mike, you're on the Run of Fez show.
Ronnie, how you doing, buddy?
Good, pal.
Hey, is Shelby in a wheelchair?
No, he's not. Why?
Well, I would think the only reason it would hold me back is if the person was handicapped, and you can't really hit a handicapped guy.
Handicapable.
Maybe. Thank you.
See, where I come from, we do not make a big deal if somebody's in a wheelchair. We just see them as a regular person. Like last night at the Eagles game, a woman went over and a guy had a prosthetic leg, so she stole it. Treating him like she would anybody else.
Sure.
It's classy.
Equal opportunity.
That's up on the iBank today. What are the other big stories up on the iBank, Chris? But, no, we don't have time to break. No,
we do. We actually have to go to break. We can get to them after the break.
I'll get to them after the show because I need the closure. What are some of the big stories out there?
Okay, look. I'm sorry to Shelby. Can we go to break now?
I don't like the way you said that. You seemed fucking like you're talking through your
teeth.
Yeah,
it didn't seem earnest.
Hurts to say this.
It seems fake.
No,
I've seen fucking happy days. I'm wrong. Just sit there and man up. Tell Shelby that you're sorry for the way you reacted to his amusing bit where he fucking treated you like a fucking, like a stooge.
Shelby, I'm sorry. Can we go to break?
Not with that fucking attitude.
I apologized. We seriously have to go to break. I apologized twice already.
I don't like the way that you're saying it, Chris. You're being very angry.
Shelby, I apologize for yelling before.
Why don't you also say it in a way that everybody can understand? Like, sorry, Shelby, I'm the fucking little bitch.
I'm not saying that. I'm not saying little bitch.
We really need to get to this break.
What the fuck would you know about breaks? Shelby, I apologize, right, for overreacting.
Like a bitch.
When you threw a water bottle at my head.
Like a bitch. And then we'll go. Because you're not calling yourself a bitch, you're saying you're acting like a bitch.
Can you say tossed instead of threw?
I'm not fucking... Shelby, I apologize for throwing the water bottle at you. Oh, no, wait. Now I'm just confused.
Ow, my head.
You're still going to have to go to HR. Just, I'm laughing away.
Yeah, I know. I fucking hear the goddamn fucking Snickers.
No, these are peanut M&Ms.
Fuck you.
Have you been wearing the same shirt for the past year?
No.
I'll get you so confused with somebody.
With who?
I don't know. Go ahead. Do your Shelby thing about where you said like a bitch and then we'll get to break.
We really need to go to break.
Well, we need to go to break the other day too and you didn't do it.
No. Shelby, I apologize for overreacting.
Like a bitch.
Like a bitch. When I yelled at you after you threw a water bottle at me. Can we go to break now?
In a minute.
Please.
Please?
We need to go to break.
You're saying for Shelby to please forgive you?
Takes a big man to admit when he's wrong, and I forgive you for me throwing the water bottle at you.
Please forgive me. It takes a big man. Some water, but I couldn't remember the last half of that.
He wasn't asking you to say that.
I didn't want you to repeat it. That was just me talking.
Look, I apologize. Can we go to break?
And it would be great if you didn't say, could we go to break? Because that sounds like now the only reason why you apologized. If you just said you apologized.
If there were no breaks, would this apology have still come?
Dave, you're on the Ron Fez show.
I have a message for Pepper there. Every time he talks, it sounds just like a rooster. Any cock will do.
It's true. Oh,
classic. Classic. You write that one yourself?
You know what? Some of the old stuff can work best. But that does sound like you.
My mouth's cock free.
For a change.
No,
Brandon, forever. You're on the Run of Fez show.
All right. Shit. Yeah, this guy's name's only going to be 2 seconds, but he's been there a couple minutes already.
This is great.
You want me to go first, or do we go?
You want to go? All right, we got to go. Chuck in Vermont.
Yo, what's going on?
Hey, man.
Victor Cruz was crying because he just realized he's on the Giants. But however,
oh, come on,
Chris, it is amazing to me
that a person with your ability to speak is actually in communications. It's incredible.
That sounds like an insult.
You're a genius. You've been on the air for a long time. Is there anybody that works at that place that doesn't have an amazing amount of saliva in their mouth?
There's a saliva that's cum.
No.
Spit it out.
Disgusting. Yeah.
Spit it out or at least fucking snowball with your fucking boyfriends. God,
I don't have any boyfriends.
I'm sorry, what's wrong?
I'm not gay. All right, we got to go to break. It's almost 1:30.
Yeah, I know. Didn't you promise them that you'd do breaks before?
Yes.
Well, we wanted to get that closure.
All right, this is closure now, right?
Okay.
Shelby.
Can we have some like light piano in the background? Or?
Yeah, give some nice, set the mood with this. I would have thought somebody would have done that on their own instead of sitting and watching the show.
How's that?
Mm-hmm. So start with Shelby, my darling.
This is very gay.
A southern accent.
Yes, use a southern accent.
Shelby, my darling.
Yes, Chris.
I apologize. I apologize for getting so angry with you after you threw a water bottle at me.
Son, you know I love you. Come here, son.
This is awkward.
Ever since Ma left, I've just been taking my anger out with water bottles. I didn't realize the damage I was doing.
Shelby, again, I apologize for being so angry after getting hit in the head with a water bottle. It was an overreaction.
And son, I accept your apology from the bottom of my heart.
I don't know what the, like, fucking opposite of fun improv is, but it would be this.
That was very strange.
Yeah.
But that was very sincere.
Oh, that's nice.
Very sincere.
That's great.
We should go to break.
I'll say, just say that. Fucked it up. Because I was just saying we were going to break. Frank, you're on the Run and Fez show.
Shelby, Chris, we know you need to go to a break. Be sincere. Look to Ron, and when Ron says the words, this is the Ron and Fez show, then you can break. But quit saying, we need to get a break. We already know.
We get it. You shouldn't have fucking promised Don that you would break so much if you couldn't fucking back it up. Lucas says you have to be a man to man up. Hicks is incapable.
Bullshit, I'm all men.
Simply the best. Iggy Pop called and he wants a stooge back. Sad though, isn't it? You must have felt terrible about your Giants last night.
I just, after Victor Cruz went down, I was like, all right, there's no point in this game.
You turned it off?
Yeah.
You can tell when some people ain't fans.
It was over, dude. Fucking when Victor Cruz goes off the field fucking crying, fuck that. That killed me.
So you're only there when things are fucking going well?
No. But just, it's been too weird a season. That just, against a divisional opponent, no. It just drove me insane.
We'll be right back. It's the Ron and Fez show.
Ron and Fez on Raw Dog.
Do you want to try your fucking M&M game?
Yeah, now that everything's calmed down, yeah.
Now, here's the problem that you're having, though.
Okay.
Who are you going to trust that is the right color? Because I didn't trust when you guys were saying that I was doing the right color.
I'll trust you.
Wait, ready?
Wait, he needs a blindfold.
That's the thing. I'm worried that...
And you'll look at the collar and you'll tell me...
Yeah.
Okay.
If you want, I can even write it down.
Okay, that's fine.
All right, here's what I'm going to do. I'll write it down before I hand it to you.
All right.
All right. Hat down.
All right, putting the hat down. I know where the mic is.
Now, any two and it's over.
Yeah.
Any two that you miss.
Yeah.
So Chris Stanley swears that he can tell the different colors between M&Ms.
Yeah.
There's the first one. Everybody see? Chris, put your hand out. It goes directly into your mouth.
Okay.
And go ahead.
I'm going to say it's red. Can I take the blindfold off?
You can see down from the bottom of your blindfold.
I swear to God, I can't. I swear to God, I did not see what I put in my mouth.
We got to do this right. We got to do this honestly.
Was it red?
Chris?
Was it red?
It was red.
Can I take the blindfold off?
Yeah.
Holy shit. I told you. Right. That's one. Five
red
more.
Red is the devil's dick. Was that M&M?
It's creepy. Red. John Taffer Jr. All right. Put the blindfold back on. Okay.
Now, what made it taste red to you?
See, I've eaten a lot of peanut M&Ms before in my life, and I always felt that the red one had a certain almost tangy flavor, and I just felt... All right. Okay, here's the next one. Okay. About to eat it. I'm going to say that was green.
Chris? Blue.
God. All right, see, I got green and blue. I get confused a lot of the time. That was just...
All right, so you're one for two.
One for two, so I get five more. Five more.
You got to hit them all now, though.
I got to hit them all in a row.
Hold on.
Okay.
So I can write it down.
All right. Feeling good, though.
I'm surprised that you even got the one.
Told you, my taste buds are great.
They don't see. You didn't get two in a row that time.
Okay. All right. I'm going to eat it.
Gotta hit this.
All right. That was yellow.
Chris?
Thank you.
I'm surprised.
Thank you.
The most nail-biting color fight I've ever been a part of. And I've been in many of them.
Like race riots?
Hat down.
All right, hat down. All right. Four more. Four more.
I am shocked. He's picking up a taste.
All right.
The fact that he had two of three correctly is shocking to me.
All right, here's the next one.
I think he's seeing under his fucking
hat. I swear to God, I don't know what I can't. I swear to God.
Maybe he can feel colors. We may not know something here.
I'm going to say, this is blue.
Chris, that was orange.
Damn it.
So we went 2 for 4.
Fuck, 50%. Jesus.
You want to try one more?
Can I try one more?
Yeah.
I'm going to put the hat back on.
You will not get your 50.
No. I gotta go to the ATM. Alright. Motherfucker! Motherfucker, who fucking threw that? That's it. Where the fuck is it?
He didn't throw it. What's the color of this?
I don't fucking know. Fucking green? I don't know.
Jeez, one water bottle throws up your taste buds.
How's another one?
Cocksucker!
You're really getting bad at this game. I mean, if anything, you don't know anything about it. Alright, do it again.
Hold on, let me get my hat.
He's orange taste blind.
Or just throw me off. All right. Get it on. Okay. Where's the next M&M?
There you go.
All right. That is... That's green. Orange again?
Do you not even want to do this?
One more. I gotta give me one more. Come
you
on.
Can't taste things that are actual flavors. You can only taste colors.
Bull, just go to hell, John Taffer Jr. I don't need your fucking comments. All right, next one. It's pretty good. All right, I'm gonna go crazy. I feel like this is a brown.
Yeah, fucking destroyed. That was yellow.
Do they make brown peanut M&Ms?
Yeah, that's a color.
No, I don't see any in here. Oh, there's... Yeah, there's a couple. Want me to give you a brown one now? See if you can do it?
Yeah, I'll take the brown.
You're just eating just a snack now. John in Iowa. John, go ahead, buddy.
Hey, Ron, I want to know if over the weekend Chris Stanley felt any bad feelings for getting you sick and fucking your weekend.
I felt never terrible. Even checked in.
I felt terrible. I never want to get Ron sick.
You just said...
Liar!
Terrible.
You said...
Liar.
I felt terrible. You didn't even fucking check in on me.
First, we're doing taste tests, then we're doing Charles Barkley impressions. That's just terrible.
Oh, fucking John Taffer Jr. is a goddamn renaissance man.
That's terrible.
Come on, Kenny. That's just terrible.
That's pretty good.
Thank you.
We should break. We need to break.
Yeah, well, not until you apologize.
Apologize to me for running down my dad.
God damn it. John Taffer Jr., I apologize for making a mockery of your father's life's work, which is renovating bars and attempting to make them successful. He's very good at it.
Mm. He's excellent at it.
He's excellent at renovating bars and giving them great concepts and turning those things around in 3.5 days.
One could almost say he rescues them.
John Taffer Sr. is great at rescuing bars.
Don is keeping an eye on all the breaks today and doesn't find this funny. And he's also writing down your fucks.
Oh, this is going to be a record day. It has to be.
No, doesn't even come close. That's the embarrassing part. We break. We're right back. Run a fest.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I present for your intellectual and philosophical pleasure...
Run Fest on Raw Dog.
Raw Dog.
Comedy Hits.
Channel.